welcome to yet another review of mobile phones at CIO East Africa magazine. ZTE Blade, or what is popularly known as Orange San Francisco. This is a phone which is available from Orange shops in Kenya, although they have not yet started advertising it or marketing it, much the way Safaricom has been marketing the ideas. The ideas has been out for a few months, since February 2011, while the San Francisco has been out for, well, we can't tell because we don't know when Orange brought it into the country. It tells us it's unlimited text and internet, San Francisco from Orange. The phone costs 12,355 shillings, and in the packaging they say that it should come with, the contents are San Francisco in white or grey, although I think what's available in the market is the grey version, the one that you see here. A 2GB micro SD card, a battery, charger, stereo headsets, an Orange quick start guide and Orange services guide and the San Francisco user guide. So let's check. So we have our phone, the battery is inside. Then these are the stereo headsets. Then over here we have the charger, which doubles up as a USB cable for the disconnect over here. Then you have a cable. It's mini USB on one side and USB on the other side to connect to the computer. Then we have SIM cards, or rather, okay, they gave us two SIM cards, you know, for what is. As you can see, it's a thin, long, with a 4.8-inch screen. At the bottom over here, we have three keys, the home key, the menu key, and the back key. San Francisco is inscribed at the top of the phone. Over on the left side, we have the mini USB port. On the right side, you have the volume keys up and down. On the top, we have the power stroke lock button and the common 3.5mm jack or the normal earphone jack, as you know it. At the bottom, just a latch for opening the back. And at the back, we have Orange and 3.2-megapixel camera. Like lid is plastic, although it has a rubber feel, with the cover for the camera. Over here we have the 2GB SD card and the SIM card slot. It's not under the battery like other phones. And you have a battery which is 1250 milliampere hour with the charging voltage of 1250 milliampere hours and a charge up voltage of up to 4.2 volts. So that's the battery. And beside it says it's Orange San Francisco, made by ZTE Corporation. As we mentioned earlier, the phone is the ZTE Blade. It's a dual band for UMTS or 3G and also dual band for GSM. I mean tri-band for GSM. So we pop back the battery. So the phone boots up with the Android icon. Then the Orange logo. There we got network. So let's continue. Our language will be English, United Kingdom. Let's go to next. It shows time as 14:08, yes, accepted. So as you can see from here, it can use the network time automatic, and you can also change to 24-hour format or 12-hour format. Select the format of the date. If you're in a different city, you can then tick here, then select the time zone of the city you want to. Over here we have an icon for the browser, which goes to the internet, the calendar, camera, Then this is a shortcut to the menu. The menu gives us quite a number of apps, as you can see. We have an app shop, probably Orange's app shop. Then the camcorder camera. We have a Google Mail. Oops, clicked on the email. Let's go back. This is the menu. There are various Orange, as you can see, the user interface is not the normal Android user interface. But then the mobile phone uses Android 2.1, otherwise known as Eclairs. Most phones at the moment use Android 2.2, that's known as Froyo, or the latest is Android 2.3, known as Gingerbread. As you can see, the normal Android one. What you're trying to do right now is look for the loudspeaker button. Looks like looks you can't looks like there's no option to listen to radio from your loudspeaker. This is however is possible in the normal Android radio app. Let's go back. Let's try another app. There's an app called TV. Let's look at what it has to offer. Takes you to the internet. It says if you're currently using a Wi-Fi connection, you won't be able to subscribe to TV or watch any existing video subscriptions. The video shop has a few videos like South Park, Zap videos, music videos, just clips. So basically what the TV app does is take you to the Orange portal containing a few apps. Let's go back and look at what other interesting app. This is Orange Maps. The installation is in French. Oops, failed. Probably not available in Kenya. Yeah, but you have Google Maps. That is the GPS icon. Manager has to offer. You can see quite a number of running applications. We can close a few we do not need to save our battery there. And maybe not need Bluetooth. Then from here you can also see the resources. At the moment you're using 29% of our CPU and 42% of our memory. It has a total of about, should be about 512 megabytes. That is the amount of RAM. You can also delete this by dragging it to the recycle bin. Let's look at what other home screens are to offer. Over here we have what we'd call a widget bar, where you can control the screen brightness, use of GPS, sync, Bluetooth, and Wi-Fi. Next section, you're going to compare the San Francisco, the Orange San Francisco, with the Huawei Ideas, which you have on the left. The Orange San Francisco is also known as the ZTE Blade. So as you can see, this is the Huawei Ideas running Android 2.2, versus the Orange San Francisco on Android 2.1 with the Orange UI. First of all, the phone, it looks like the Huawei IDS is heavier than the San Francisco. This is lighter than this. Then at the same time, when you look at other physical differences, of course, as you can see, the San Francisco is bigger. Yeah, that is just a larger head than the Huawei IDS. Then looking at the thickness, quite thin. At the IDS, this is the power button, and this is the earphone jack. The same over here for the San Francisco. That was the thickness. Then the buttons. When you look at the front, you see that the Huawei IDS has, at the bottom, has four function buttons. This is the back button, the settings button, the home button, and the search button. You can use this to scroll. This is not present in the San Francisco. Towards the back, this is the difference between the two phones. We can see that the IDS has volume buttons on the left, where the San Francisco has them in USB port. Then to the right, we have the volume buttons on the San Francisco, and probably a speaker down here, while the IDS does not have anything on the right side. As you can see, the San Francisco clearly has a bigger screen. The IDS fits perfectly and leaves some space when on the IDS, both on the width and the height. The IDS screen also part of the, like a third of the, yeah, a third of the screen is occupied by the function keys, and the San Francisco has, the screen occupies most of the, or almost 90% of the front eyes. And another thing, you can unlock the IDS from the joystick, but for the San Francisco, you have to press on the power key to unlock the. So you guys, looking at the menu, you can see the difference in the. Okay, the IDS contains some of the applications I've installed over the several months I've been using it, while the San Francisco has stock applications, including Docs2Go. So this look again, looking at the home screen of the two phones, this is how different they look. A bit different. Well, this is the normal Android keypad. This is the keypad that Orange has customized on their San Francisco phone. Notice the Alt key. Both of them are QWERTY keyboards. And down here, as you can see, to go to numbers and other keys and other characters, you press 1, 2, 3 on the normal Android keypad. Over here, you press this. And it has 5 pages where you can scroll with numbers and other characters. For the normal Android keyboard, use the Alt function. From reviews online, they say that the San Francisco has 4 times more pixels on the screen than those on the IDS, so it should be 4 times clearer with both cameras. If you're able to see, you can see that the view from the San Francisco camera is a bit clearer, is sharper than that from the IDS camera. Let's take a few shots. There is our result on both phones. Let's try installing Angry Birds on both devices and see what the gaming experience will be. So for the ideas already has Angry Birds installed. Let's try starting it. As you can see from putting both devices side to side, you have a lot of real estate to play around with on the San Francisco compared to the ideas. And as also the San Francisco has a sharper screen and has a sharper game. Let's do one game. Guru in the YouTube experience on both fonts. So start the YouTube application. Then let's search for Bugs Bunny. So the video loads in landscape mode. On the San Francisco. Let's see the keys from the wedding. From the royal wedding. Yeah, that was fast. And Piero. We are going to try installing Google Docs on both devices from the Android market. So you're going to search for Docs. So looks like Google Docs is not available for the ideas, while Google Docs is available for the San Francisco. The search for Docs on both devices, on the San Francisco, 378 applications are available versus 255 applications available for the ideas. So as you can see, some applications may not be really available on the ideas. You might have to go work a way around to installing that, or they may be available for the San Francisco, probably due to the larger screen size and the faster processor in the San Francisco. That will be all for today. Thank you.